polymers are known for hundreds of years, more or less, nearly since the discovery of Marie Curie. But at the same time, there is a continuous search of how to make these polymers better defined, because chemistry is really about selectivity, it's about really making compounds which are more and more tailor-made. So it's a question how we can act as tailors, how we can make molecules which are crafted exactly the way we want. And this is something which is a big challenge, because these are very huge molecules, not like organic molecules of molar mass, let's say 100, but sometimes 100,000 or maybe a million or maybe even tens of millions. How to make them with a precisely controlled composition or shape or even distribution of sizes. This is really a big challenge, but it offers tremendous possibility of making new materials with new properties. Sometimes even, let's say, intelligent materials, materials which would respond to light, temperature, pH change, or even pressure or temperature or something else. You know, you cannot plan discoveries. So, you know, sometimes you have an experiment which may be expected, maybe sometimes unexpected. It's a question how you can follow it up and how you can really believe in one thing, as in some sense Marie Curie believed in this radioactivity. Sometimes maybe, you know, wrong thing, sometimes maybe naive, but I think what is needed is in some sense you know, believing, or in some sense really trusting that it's worth it. Because if you have a passion, you can do it, you can work day and night. And sometimes, now if I dream about something, I have solutions even, or ideas coming at 2 at night. And then, you know, because I think about it, it's probably she had exactly the same feeling. We always had a little bit different challenge, and something which was very challenging some time ago becomes obvious, and then you do a new thing. And I think every week sometimes gives you a new challenge, and sometimes you don't know how to solve it, and if you solve it, it becomes obvious, and then you have a new challenge and next challenge. And I think this is what gives you a kind of the feeling young and feeling challenged and feeling insecure in some sense, because you don't know how to solve that, and you face nature. Sometimes you are lucky, sometimes you are not, sometimes you succeed, sometimes you don't, and sometimes you discover which you didn't think about.
And you proceed despite that insecurity and despite that not knowing.
I think it's more challenging.